Hi, this is Vivek. I'm very excited to share this very interesting puzzle with you. A few days back, I asked this puzzle. We have to arrange 52 numbers from 1 to 52 in some peculiar way. Alright, the first number should be the largest number, that is 52, and each number has to appear exactly once in this sequence. So we need to form a finite sequence with the initial term as 52, and all the other terms should follow this condition, that the next term should divide the sum of all the previous terms. The n plus 1th term should divide sum of all the first n terms. Alright, and we have to find such a sequence. There can be many such sequences, and we just have to find only one sequence. Alright, that gives us enough freedom to play around a bit. Okay, to understand the problem better, consider the case 3, 1, 2. We have the largest number as the initial term 3. And the next term 1 divides 3, and the next term 2 divides 3 plus 1. Alright, 3 plus 1. So, in this way, we have to form a finite sequence of 52 numbers. Okay, that is the task. Now, let us proceed to the solution. Let the numbers be A1, A2, let the sequence be A1, A2, A3, and so on. So, this is such a sequence. And let Sn be the sum of first n terms. Sum of first n terms. Right, and by the given condition, n plus 1th term, a n plus 1, should divide the sum of first n terms, that is a n plus 1 should divide Sn. That means Sn is the multiple of a n plus 1, and we can write Sn as f of n into a n plus 1. Now f of n is some factor, right? We let that to be a function of n. Right, so Sn is equal to f of n into a n plus 1, and this is our user defined function. This can be anything, we don't know yet. Alright, let that be. Now consider Sn plus 1. Sn plus 1 is equal to Sn plus a n plus 1. This is because sum of first n plus 1 terms is equal to sum of first n terms plus n plus 1 term. So Sn plus 1, using this general equation, we can write Sn plus 1 as f of n plus 1 into a n plus 2, and Sn can be written as f of n into a n plus 1 plus a n plus 1. Remember, we don't know what the function f of n is. So this gives f of n plus 1 into a n plus 2 is equal to f of n plus 1 into a n plus 1. Right? Now f of n can be any function, and we try to find some easier function so that the sequence can be written easier. One such possibility is f of n plus 1 can be a n plus 1, and f of n plus 1 can be a n plus 2. This is one simple possibility, and we don't know whether this is possible. Let us check that out. So what we have, f of n plus 1 is equal to a n plus 1. This means in general f of n is equal to a n, and f of n plus 1 is equal to a n plus 2 here. Alright, since f of n is equal to a n, we have this gives a n plus 1 is equal to a n plus 2. In other words, a n plus 2 is equal to a n plus 1. So we got a nice recurrence relation. So this is one important thing, a n plus 2 is equal to a n plus 1, and remember f of n is equal to a n, and also remember Sn is equal to f of n into a n plus 1. So Sn is equal to f of n into a n plus 1, and f of n we know that is a n, so we have this. Sn is equal to a n into a n plus 1, and a n plus 2 is equal to a n plus 1. Now let us try to verify this, okay? Alright, by induction. Suppose, for now let us not worry about the base cases, let us try the induction part, alright, to check whether this can work. Alright, so suppose Sn is equal to a n into a n plus 1. Consider Sn plus 1. Sn plus 1 is equal to Sn plus An plus 1, sum of first n terms plus n plus 1th term. And Sn is equal to An into An plus 1 by the assumption, inductive assumption. So this gives An plus 1 into An plus 1. And An plus 1 by this recurrence relation is An plus 2. So this is An plus 1 into An plus 2. Because An plus 1 is An plus 2 by our recurrence relation. So this proves that in general Sn is equal to a n into a n plus 1, that is Sn is the multiple of n plus 1th term, so n plus 1th term divides Sn, so everything falls correct, right? Now we have found this nice form, but we have to find the base case that makes this work. That is an important thing, right? So we need to find first few terms that satisfy these two properties, especially this one, this property. If the base case follows this property, then if we use this recurrence to find the further elements of the sequence, then that will satisfy our condition that n plus 1th term should divide Sn, sum of Sn terms. Okay, now the task is to find the base case. Now consider A1 is 52. That is fixed, right? The first number should be the largest number, and that is the given condition. In general, let us take some even number in this term. So A1 is equal to 2n, some even number. And what can be A2? A2 can be any term that divide 2n. Let us take the simple terms. So what about 1? Alright, consider the case when A1 is equal to 52 and A2 is equal to 1. Therefore, A3 must divide 52 plus 1. 52 plus 1 is 53, and 53 is prime number, and A3 has to be 53, but these elements cannot exceed 52, as every element has to be from 1 to 52. Therefore, this is not possible. Alright, A2 is equal to 1 may not be possible in all cases. So let us try A2 is equal to 2. Right, so this divides 2n. And what about A3? Now, S2 is equal to 2n plus 2. A1 plus A2, 2n plus 2. And this is 2 into n plus 1. Alright. And we have used this 2 already in the second place. So, we can try n plus 1 in the third place. So, we can take A3 to be n plus 1. Now, consider A4. So, A4 should divide S3. What is S3? S3 is S2 plus A3. And S2 is 2 into n plus 1, and A3 is again n plus 1, so this is 3 into n plus 1. Alright, so A4, we can take 3. We have used the n plus 1 already in the third place, so we can take 3. So we have 3 here. Now observe that we have S3 is equal to 3 into n plus 1, and 3 is A4, the next term. And n plus 1 is the current term, A3. So this satisfies this crucial condition here. Sn is equal to an into an plus 1. So this base case satisfies this crucial condition, right? And also, an plus 2 is equal to an plus 1. A4 is equal to a2 plus 1. And also, this satisfies this condition too. Great. Now we have found the sequence, right? So this base case will work. So we have found the sequence. All we need to do is remember that an plus 2 is equal to an plus 1. We use this recurrence to generate the rest of the elements. So the first term is 2n, the next term is 2, and the third term is n plus 1. And we have to add 1 here, and the next number we have to add 1 here, n plus 2, and the next number we have to add 4. So we have to fill 2, 3, 4, and we put a gap here, and 5, and so on, till n plus n minus 1, right? See, we have n plus 2 here, and we have 2 plus 1, 3 here, right? And we have n plus 1 here, so 1 plus 1, 2 here. Therefore, in the final term, we have n plus n minus 1, and the previous term will be n. So this will cover all the elements. So this will be 2n minus 1, this will end with 2n minus 1, and this sequence will cover all the elements from 1 to 2n. So 1 is missing, right? And 1 divides any element, so we can add 1 at the last, right? So we can add 1 at the last. That won't affect anything, because 1 divides any number, so we can safely add 1 at the last. So this finite sequence satisfies all the property, all the condition that our question has. So we have found such sequence. Let us see how this works by taking some cases. What about 8? So 2 into 4 are 8, so n is equal to 4. So we have 8 here, and we should start with 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, no, wait. We have 2. So we have 4 here, therefore 2 4s are 8, and we need to continue this till 4, and we have to wind up this, right? We have n plus 1 here, so we have 5 here, so we have 6 here, and we have 7 here, and we have to add 1 at the last. Let us try another example. I got confused a little bit in the middle. So what if n is equal to 5? So 2n is 10, and the next number should be 3, and we have to fill this till the number 5, right? 2, 3, 4, 5, and wind up here, 10 plus 1, 6, 7, 8, and finally add 1. So these are the sequences, right? And by the way we constructed this sequence, this has to satisfy our property. Let us check that out. 8, so 2 divides 8, 8 plus 2 is 10, 10 is divided by 5, 10 plus 5, 15, 3 divides 15, 15 plus 3, 18, 6 divides 18, so 18 plus 6, 24, 4 divides 24, 24 plus 4, 28, 7 divides 28, 28 plus 7, whatever it is divided by 1, so this works, right? Similarly, we can say 10 plus 2, we can easily check this out, right? So this is how we can form the general sequence. Now, we can use the same thing for the for when n is equal to 26, in this case, the original problem. So we have 52 and 2, 3, 4, and so on up to 26. And we have to wind up here, 27, 28, and so on till 51. And we have to add 1 that we lost. So we have found one such sequence. So that is it. Isn't it great? And we can also find the general format for odd numbers, when the largest number is the odd number. Initially we have 52, right? Instead of 52, if we have 53, what we can do? That we can easily work out, right? Suppose we have a1 is equal to 2n plus 1. We can add a2 to be 1. So 2n plus 1 plus 1 is 2n plus 2. So a3 can be 2 or n plus 1. So we can continue like this, right? I leave it for you to work out the solution for the odd number case. So this is it. This is really amazing, right? Okay, thanks for watching. Bye.